Now, Access Tech Live headlines.
Oh, a little bit strongly, Stephen. Apple made a rare evening announcement earlier this week. Monday night, to be exact, all decked out for Halloween. The 30-minute spooky event was short and sweet, but it debuted the company's latest processors, the M3, M3 Pro, and M3 Max.
With 3-nanometer technology, a next-generation GPU architecture, a higher-performance CPU, faster neural engine, and support for even more unified memory, they're the most advanced chips ever built for a personal computer.
As Apple Senior Vice President of Hardware Engineering John Ternus, the new chips offer a faster, more efficient CPU, upgraded graphics processing, and make even gaming stand out, which is pretty cool. Now, following the chip announcement, Apple unveiled the first new computers to feature the new processors. Here's Apple's Vice President again of Hardware Engineering, John Ternus.
Well, tonight, thanks to the efficiency of Apple Silicon, we're giving iMac a giant leap in performance while keeping the same impossibly thin design and spectrum of 7 vibrant colors. With M3, iMac is up to 2 times faster than iMac with M1. And you'll feel its speed and power in everything you do, from multitasking across everyday productivity apps to exploring creative passions like editing high-resolution photos or multiple streams of 4K video.
The 24-inch iMac got its first update in a long time, including not only M3 chips, but also a 4.5K retina display, support for Wi-Fi 6E, and an upgraded 1080p webcam. The new iMac started $1,699 Canadian and can be pre-ordered today with availability starting next week, November the 7th. Apple is also updating the MacBook Pros to include the new M3 processors. Here's Kate Bergeron, Apple's VP of Hardware Engineering.
With the power of the M3 family of chips, up to 22 hours of battery life, a stunning Liquid Retina XDR display, and advanced connectivity. There's simply no other laptop like MacBook Pro.
Oh, definitely not. Both the 14 and 16-inch versions of the MacBook Pro feature a mini LED display, 1080p webcam, 22 hours of battery life, and a brand new color, space black. That's exciting, with a coating that's supposed to help reduce fingerprints. We'll see that when we get our hands on it. Good old-fashioned silver will also still be available. Now, both models of the MacBook Pro are available to pre-order right now and will also be available starting November 7th. It's next week. The 14-inch model starts at $2,099 Canadian. You can boost that up pretty high, which we'll talk about a bit later. Alongside the M3 Pro and M3 Max-equipped MacBook Pro, Apple is releasing a cheaper 14-inch MacBook Pro model. That one comes with just the base M3 chip. Now, this one replaces the 13-inch MacBook Pro with the M2 chip that Apple released last year. This one is 60% faster and finally gets rid of that dreaded touch bar. Finally, Pringles, yep, the chip maker, you know, Nestle, who owns them, is collaborating with NaviLens technology to make their packaging more accessible to the visually impaired. The new packaging features NaviLens technology, which lets smartphones easily detect an on-pack code. So when you point it at the actual product, you enable playback of a label information, which is pretty cool. The first adaptive label will roll out any day now, with a complete rollout of its products by the end of 2024. And those, Stephen, are your headlines for this week.
There you go. It was a lot of chip news. A lot of chip news in there this week, which is kind of cool. M3s and Pringles. I don't think we'd ever bring those two together in a tech show, but there you go. We did it. And you know, that's great news. Again, it's just making products more accessible, right? And it's such a cool feature, because what people don't realize with the QR code that you get from NaviLens is that the iPhone or the Android phone that's scanning for it can actually see it from quite a distance. So you could be walking down the aisle of a superstore and you'd be able to hold your phone up and it would be able to tell you the products in that aisle. So it's super cool.
That's very cool. You know, one of the things we didn't talk about, and we can talk about it later, the Apple event, and the biggest buzz from the Apple event this week wasn't just the new products, but it was the fact that right at the end, there was a little thing on the screen that said this event was filmed entirely on an iPhone and edited on a Mac. And that's the takeaway that everybody's talking about in the tech space. But it is pretty cool that they're actually using their own devices and kind of putting the proof where the pudding is and showing that, yeah, you could film a keynote. Granted, there was a little bit of assistance, which we could talk about a bit later.
Yeah, I think so. You know, I thought the big takeaway was space black. But anyway, we'll get to all that. We're going to break all that down a bit later. I want to move on to our question of the day today, because this is a great question. And we've already been getting responses online. I imagine we're going to have so many by the end of the show. The question this week is, what one piece of movie tech from our past do you wish came true? That's such a great question, right? It could be absolutely anything. It could be the flying car, you know, Marty McFly's hoverboard and Back to the Future. I mean, there's lots of options, right?
Oh, Tony Stark's transparent cell phone. I mean, there's so many options. And here's the trick, guys, okay? If you follow us on social media at Access Tech Live, you'll find out about the question a couple days before the show is here live. So you'll be able to get involved and get in on the show and actually tell us what your opinion is. Lots of really cool ideas coming in, which we'll definitely get to later on. So again, the question of the week this week is, what is the one piece of movie tech from our past? Of course, it could be all of our past, collective past. Do you wish came true? It could be the flying car. Could be Marty McFly's hoverboard from Back to the Future, maybe Tony Stark's transparent cell phone. Email us feedback@accesstechlive.com, connect on all social media at Access Tech Live, and we will get to those questions a bit later on the show. But first, we take a quick break here at Access Tech Live and come back with part one of our conversation with Apple's Sarah Herlinger. Stick around.
We want to hear from you. Follow us on social media and get involved at Access Tech Live. We'll be right back.